people in your knowledge may be of the same or different gender, but you must keep an open mind to accept and listen to them.
Hey everyone, welcome to new podcast series of Hear Quiz Stories, Stronger Together Amidst Adversities in Southeast Asia, brought to you by Came Out of the Closet and Asian Sogi Caucus.
Series of podcast episodes which will be made available both in our Spotify account as well as in YouTube. It's intended really to bring so much space for LGBTI voices from Southeast Asia to be heard, to share our stories, and also to find out how folks like us will be able to work together in transforming the ASEAN region.
Welcome to our podcast series, Hear Queer Stories, listen to the LGBTIQ narrative from Southeast Asia, in collaboration with ASEAN Sogi Caucus, with Farah, Proud and Rhys. This series is on Stronger Together amidst adversities as a queer community in a time of pandemic in Southeast Asia, covering 6 episodes and featuring multiple queer guest speakers across the region. And today is the 3rd episode of the series. We will be discussing the topic around queer and freedom of expression. How does it matter?
In this episode, we've got Patricia from Girl X Girl Thailand, an organization that supports Thailand's LGBTIQIA+ movements and a Pride Parade volunteer in the USA before. Thailand has been known as a paradise for the LGBTQIA+ community in Southeast Asia, while on the other hand, controversies arise by the government as the law itself contradicts. Few months ago, Thailand's Constitutional Court ruled that Section 1448 of the Civil and Commercial Code defined marriages as only between men and women in the Constitution. The judgment was discriminative, and this has angered out and frustrated the LGBTQIA+ community.
Before, that was one of the recent current affairs in Thailand. So, let's talk about our guest now. Patricia, tell us more about yourself.
Yes, my name is Patricia. I was born in US and I grew up in Thailand. I raised up in Chiang Mai, is north of Thailand. And last year, I created a Girl X Girl committee that is a woman-loving woman committee that is built up to connect every woman-loving woman that is express themselves as a lesbian, queer, bisexual, trans-lesbian, or any gender that you would like to express themselves, and you can exchange the opinion and joining the activity together.
Nice. Question 1. As a Thai queer woman and you had experience living in the US, what is the significant difference in terms of expressing yourself and your opinion in US and here in Thailand?
It has 2 aspects in my opinion. The first is evaluation of others. Every time you introduce yourself in the United States, you will say your name and pronouns, although the pronouncement has nothing to do with your biological sex or our appearance. The other does not pass judgment and ask why. They simply admire you for who you are. In the other hand, if you identify yourself or your partner with a gender expression that is different from your appearance, they will ask why or inquire about the details of how you have sex, such as who is the masculine and who is the feminine one.
Wow, that's a bit too like intimate details, right? Personal, don't you think so?
Yes, it is. Sometimes they give this question on the first time that we met. So,
wow.
And the second aspect is societal acceptance. You can be yourself and live your life as you like, such as applying for school or a job based on your gender expression. When I live in the US, United States, I will see the transgender people working in a frontline position, such as reception, public relations, bank clerk, and cashier. In Thailand, however, if you dress up and express a gender other than your biological one, you will not be high on the first year.
Oh my, this is really terrible for all our trans siblings.
Now some company is open mind, but I think almost The other is no, just a few one.
So now we'll proceed to question two. How does democracy help maintain freedom and bring equality to society according to your opinion?
Democracy, in my perspective, refer to a belief in individual liberty and equality, as well as a political system. Human rights will be supported by democracy, which allow people to voice what they think and wish as long as it does not disrupt others. Citizens have the right to be themselves, while the government must develop the country's infrastructure to sustain them. For example, the government provides a good gender education to all students, beginning in the primary school, and create a safe environment for all genders, such as a public restroom, school, and a job that are accessible to all sex. In conclusion, democracy represents freedom and equality, and it promotes diversity of people, not only in terms of gender, but also in terms of lifestyle, in order for the country to be a happy place to live.
Yeah, recently even I've seen the there was this toilet in Phuket, I think, if I'm not wrong, they have this gender non-binary toilet.
It makes us feel included inside and we are real.
Yes, I agree with that.
Yeah.
Oh, that's very cool for you all to have these things in Thailand, because we don't even have them in Singapore. In Southeast Asia, it's definitely a tiny step to progress. Okay, so for the next question, a lot of non-Thai see that Thailand is an LGBTQIA plus paradise, but denies their citizens' demands for marriage equality, marriage protection from discrimination on gender and sexual orientation, which have been the recent issues. Do you think the legal systems are in place right now in Thailand that will allow the liberation of queer Thais anytime soon? And how has this impacted the LGBTQIA plus community?
It's difficult to say yes, despite the fact that many visitors come to attend the cabaret show or consult for a gender transition. Marriage equality is illegal in Thailand, in reference to the prior question. LGBTQIA plus persons in Thailand have struggled to express themselves, and they are unable to be who they want for fear of rejection. They must excel in all areas, including school, employment, and being a good people for others, regardless of gender. Furthermore, some LGBTQIA plus people are unable to decide who they want to be or how they want to dress, because it may have an impact on their friends, school, university, work, or society.
Do you envision Thailand to follow SOGC recommendations during the Universal Periodic Review? And how we as the LGBTQIA plus community exercising our right to be free to express and push the legal system for bringing more equal rights to Thais? Same-sex marriage, discrimination on the basis of gender identity and sexual orientation, and enactment of gender identity, gender expression, and sex characteristics act were recommended by Israel, Canada, few countries in Europe and Latin America.
As up in the third Universal Periodic Review, or UPR, Thailand's government received recommendation to safeguard freedom of expression, access to information, the right to protest, and digital rights. I hope the Thai government makes all of these recommendations a priority and implement them as soon as possible. Moreover, given that Thailand received SOGC recommendation at the second Universal Periodic Review and again during the third UPR, I am hopeful that it will assist the government in better understanding LGBTQ rights and considering marriage equality legislation. How we as LGBTQIA+ committee exercising our right to be free to express and push the legal system for bringing more equal rights to Thais. I would like to make two suggestions. The first, whether you are straight or LGBTQ+, you must have an open mind to listen to and learn about other people's differences. People in your knowledge may be of the same or different gender, but you must keep an open mind to accept and listen to them for who they are. Second, supporting LGBTQ plus life as much as possible means sharing your information with others, attending LGBTQ plus event, signing petition to promote LGBTQ legislation, and donating money to the marriage equality movement. I understand that achieving equal life is difficult, but if we work together, we will be able to achieve it in our own country. We can do two things first. The first thing is less awareness. As I said in the before that, we have a Women Loving Women Committee. We have the open chat that can talk 24 hours. We can sharing with each of our opinion and sharing the LGBTQ events or sharing the signing marriage equality website to encourage everyone to sign in that website in the same time. And every Thursday evening, 8 p.m. on at Thailand time, we will have the Clubhouse or Twitter space to speaking to exchange our opinion and in the topic about the LGBTQIA plus that give everyone to know more about SOGIEC or LGBTQ knowledge or gender information. One can join and learn with each other. We just have to open mind and to listen to and learn about the other people that way they would like to be, and they would, and sometimes they different as, but sometimes we are similar. We have to learn each other's.
Everyone check them out. You can see Facebook Girl X Girl. And Twitter, Girl X Girl TH. Instagram, Girl X Girl Thailand. YouTube, Girl X Girl. So Spotify as well. Yeah. And also email, girlxgirlthailand@gmail.com.
In your opinion, in our community, we have segregation, like trans people stay with trans or gays stay with gays. Basically, they don't want to mingle with each other. So sometimes our opinions may sound transphobic or homophobic within our community, but not to us. What do you think?
I think it will be the sad community that you cannot express who you are and choose to born. But after you born, why you have to got the chosen from the other that which gender that you have to be? You have the right to do what you want, and the other have to respect and accept that.
How did you feel when you lived in the US and in Thailand?
In US, I feel they open to every, they open for except for other diversity of the people. They accept the different people that, and they accept the people that sometimes is not look like the others. And and after you, I feel like after you got the knowledge and you accept it, you will support it in the in the final. But in Thailand, I think we have just a few knowledge about the gender or the LGBTQ knowledge. Some people don't know about the intersex, that some people just have few knowledge about lesbian that only have the bush and femme or one masculine, one feminine. Or in Thailand, we have the, just the stereotype about the gay men. Some people don't accept for the gay men that is have really, really feminine in in the movie series. So I think if in Thailand we open mind to for the accept the other as who they are, and we after we accept, we will support it and we will learn the other more than that. Because I think if we accept, we will be accept to the school, job, and society will we connect each other, and we can live easier
Correct. Acceptance is deeper than that. It comes to our welfare, employment, schools, and even toilets, because these places are the ones that we get discriminated. Acceptance is just not like, hey, I accept you, but it's deeper in every aspect of life that intersects with who we are and where we wish to go to. Do you think society there is progressing, or is still the same, or going backwards according to your experience?
I think in Thailand that we are going forward. But it's just a little bit than the other country. Oh, wow. Yeah. For example, I see in the television, the series or movie in television that in 10 years ago, the LGBTQ people will got the accept job on the TV show just for entertainment.
Employment is so important because we all need a career and financial security. Unfortunately, we still do get rejected because of who we are. That's very sad, and a lot of them end up in poverty. Usually in the entertainment industry, it's a stepping stone for many of us, and it's very important to have queer representation in the media. And having queer representation in Thailand's media is definitely a sign of progression.
Yeah, this will be very important, especially for the future generation.
Especially we fight for this.
So what we have learned from Patricia, Thailand is definitely setting the pace forward for this ASEAN region. Everything is a small growth, but like I mentioned before, we will eventually reach there. And I think Thailand is definitely a role model for a lot of our countries.
I'm very glad that Patricia shared on legal systems in Thailand and joining this podcast. Thank you, Patricia, for being here.
Thank you so much. Well,
alright folks, let's wrap this up and catch up with us in our next episode. Don't forget to follow Girl X Girl for more on their movements and conversational spaces on Instagram at Girl X Girl Thailand, or their Twitter Girl X Girl TH, and on their Clubhouse account. Thank you for listening. Follow us on Instagram at Came Out of the Closet IG and ASEAN Sugi Caucus. Catch the video on our Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. Stay tuned for our next episode.